Hello everyone. In the previous lectures, we learned about what is artificial intelligence, machine learning, applications of machine learning, what is the classification of machine learning tasks, an application of machine learning called spam email detection. Then we have seen what is the ingredients of machine learning, tasks, features, and models. We have discussed in detail about tasks and how to assess the performance of different machine learning models with respect to different tasks. Today we are going to learn about the next ingredient of machine learning called models. Myself, Dr. G.N.V.G. Sirisha, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in SRKR Engineering College. The objectives of today's lecture are learn about machine learning models, to classify machine learning models, and understand the concepts of linear separability, non-linear separability, and discuss in detail about geometric models like SVM, KNN, and K-means clustering. What is a model? Model forms the central concept in machine learning as they are what is being learned from data in order to solve a given task. There are a wide range of machine learning models. Machine learning models can be classified into geometric models, probabilistic models, and logical models. Geometric models are based on the intuition from geometry such as separating hyperplanes, linear transformations, and distance metrics. Probabilistic models view learning as a process of reducing uncertainty, modeled by means of probability distributions. Logical models are defined in terms of easily interpretable logical expressions. Alternatively, models can be categorized into grouping models and grading models. Grouping models divide the instance space into segments, and in each segment, a very simple model is learned. Grading model learns a single global model over the entire instance space. Geometric models. In geometric models, the instance space is set of all possible or describable instances, whether they are present in our dataset or not. For instance, if all features are numerical, then we can use each feature as a coordinate in a Cartesian coordinate system. A geometric model is constructed directly in the instance space using geometric concepts such as lines, planes, or distances. For instance, a linear classifier that we have discussed earlier, given by the equation sigma I is equal to 1 to n wi xi greater than t, is a geometric classifier. One main advantage of geometric classifiers is that they are easy to visualize as long as we keep the number of dimensions to 2 or 3. The other geometric models are support vector machines, k nearest neighbor classification, k means clustering, K-medoids clustering, etc. In geometric models, it is important to keep in mind that a Cartesian instance space has as many coordinates as there are features, which can be tens or hundreds or thousands or even more. Such high dimension spaces are hard to imagine, but are nevertheless very common in machine learning. Geometric concepts that potentially apply to high dimension spaces are usually prefixed with hyper. For instance, a decision boundary in an unspecified number of dimensions is called hyperplane. Linear separability. What is linear separability? If there exists a linear decision boundary separating two classes, we say that the data is linearly separable. We can see that in this diagram, the data belongs to two different classes. One, all the data points belonging to one class are shown with the help of plus symbol, and all the data points which belong to the other class are shown with the help of minus symbol. You can see there is one linearly separable line which separates these two data points belonging to two different classes. So we are able to separate the data points belonging to two different classes with the help of a line. Such type of data is called linearly separable data. But data is usually noisy. Linear separability does not occur very often in practice unless the data is very sparse, as in text classification. For example, recall that we used a large vocabulary, say 10,000 words, each word corresponding to a Boolean feature indicating whether or not the word occurred in a document. This means the instance space has 10,000 dimensions. But for any one document, no more than small percentage of these features will be non-zero. As a result, there is much empty space between instances, which increases the possibility of linear separability. However, because linear separable data does not uniquely define a decision boundary, we are now faced with a problem. Which of the infinitely many decision boundaries should we choose? For example, if you look at this data, there can be infinite number of lines which can separate the points belonging to the plus class from the points belonging to the minus class. So we can draw infinite number of lines in between these two points. So there are infinite number of possible decision boundaries. So which decision boundary we have to choose? One natural option is to prefer large margin classifiers, where the margin of a linear classifier is the distance between the decision boundary and the closest instance. Support vector machines are a powerful kind of linear classifier that find a decision boundary whose margin is as large as possible. For example, if you look at this diagram, we can say a support vector machine which identifies this decision boundary, which separates the data points belonging to plus class from the data points belonging to the minus class with the help of support vectors. The circled data points are called as the support vectors. The next important geometric concept is distance. Distance is a very important geometric concept in machine learning. If the distance between two instances is small, then the instances are similar in terms of their feature values. And so nearby instances could be expected to receive the same classification or belong to the same cluster. In the Cartesian coordinate system, distance can be measured by Euclidean distance, which is given by square root of sum of square distances along each coordinate. K nearest neighbor classifier is one of the geometric classifier. A very simple distance-based classifier called k-nearest neighbor classifier works as follows. To classify a new instance, it retrieves the most similar training instance from the memory. That is, the training instance with the smallest distance from the instance that has to be classified is retrieved from the memory. And it simply assigns the class of the nearest training instance to the new instance. This classifier is called nearest neighbor classifier. We can also retrieve the k most similar training instances and take a OAT. That is, instead of retrieving the most similar instance to the new instance, we retrieve k similar instances from the memory or training data set, and whichever class is the majority class among the k most similar training instances, that class will be assigned to the new instance. Sometimes each of these k similar training instances also will be given different weights, where the weight of a training instance is inversely proportional to its distance from the new instance. Here we can see an example to KNN. Here the data set belongs to two different classes, class A and class B. All the data points belonging to class A are shown using red color. All the data points belonging to class B are shown using green color. Now the new instance which has to be classified is shown using the yellow color. So in the KNN classifier, the end user has to specify the k value. Here, if we take the k value as 1, when a new instance has to be classified, we will find the most similar training instance from the training dataset, which is similar to the new instance. In this diagram, you can see out of all these training instances, this particular red instance is most closer to the new instance in terms of distance. So the class to which this particular instance belongs, that class will be assigned to the new instance. So you can see this most similar instance belongs to class A. So the new instance will be assigned class A. So how do we calculate the similarity between instances in KNN? The similarity between instances, that is new instance and each of the training instances, is calculated using distance measures. So the distance measures like Euclidean distance, Manhattan distance, etc. can be used. So similarity is inversely proportional to the distance between the new instance and the training instance. Now, if we take k is equal to 3, means instead of finding the most similar instance to the new instance, now we will find 3 instances from the training dataset which are highly similar to the new instance. So now, among all the training instances, you can see this particular star and these two triangles are more similar or closer to the new instance in terms of distance. So these three will be selected. Out of these three instances, two instances belong to the class B, one instance belong to class A. So the majority class is class B. So class B will be assigned to the new instance. The k-nearest classifier can also be applied for regression tasks. In regression, we predict a numerical value, unlike in classification where we predict a categorical value. For example, suppose I want to predict the salary of an employee based on the attributes or features of an employee. So that is called a regression task. So when KNN has to be applied for regression, we apply a similar procedure to classification. Based on the k value, we choose k nearest neighbors from the training data to the new instance. For example, if k is equal to 1, we choose 1 nearest neighbor to the new instance. If these two represent employees, the new employee salary will be predicted as same as the salary of this red employee represented by red star. If k value is 3, now 3 employees from the training data who are highly similar to the new employee will be selected. Now the salary of the new employee will be taken as the average salary of these 3 employees from the training data. That is how KNN can be applied for regression tasks. So KNN, when we use KNN for prediction, the predictions are local. They are based on only a few training instances rather than being derived from the global model built from the entire dataset. This particular rule applies for all the geometric models also. So, the summary of today's lecture is, today we have learnt about what is a model, what is the classification of models, what are geometric models, what are the geometric concepts like lines, planes and distances, and we have learned in detail about geometric classifiers like linear classifier, support vector machine, and k-nearest neighbor classifier. Thank you.